Think of this 20 years from now, and someone's watching this. What would you like them to know about you?
Well, let's see. You know, you don't think about it. I have trouble with emotions. I get so mad at myself because I can't control my emotions. That's my big problem.
Nothing wrong with that.
Well, that's what they say. But it makes me mad. My name's Mary Ann. They chose that name for me, and I'm real thankful for it. I was born on the 6th of September, 1930, in a farmhouse just about a mile south of here. I put a string of beads around her neck with a little bell on them. So she got outside and wandered away, we could find her. I was a little kid, I suppose, I don't know, 4 or 5 years old. Maybe I wasn't that old, but we had had company, and they were all calling my mom Ann. So I kind of thought, well, that's kind of nice. I'll call her Ann the next time I talk to her. So I did, and boy, did I ever get, I mean, that's a slap I can still feel. She was always a good little girl. Stayed around the house. No, she never got into trouble. I always thought my dad was pretty strict, but I'm thankful. I probably found out more about him by what other people knew of him than what, you know, I would know.
He liked to have us girls. He was teaching us how to sing Galway Bay, the Irish song, and he, I can remember him putting us up. Remember that? Putting us up on the kitchen table. And do you remember that?
I don't remember Galway Bay.
You do? Yeah. He'd put us up on the kitchen table and have us sing.
You know, he made sure we did the right thing. And we're kind of scared not to do the right thing. We think we're doing it all the time. I already had a brother when I was born. His name was John.
There was a time when they put the bathtub, which was just a regular old wash tub, if you know what I'm talking about. And they set it behind the stove. And Mary Ann was taking her bath behind the stove. And somehow or another, she stood up and she got too close to the stove. And she burned her hand.
I had a brother, Dan, who died pretty young. He was in an accident. I remember that real well. I was in first grade at Gary Old School. And we already had Terry by that time. And I remember Mike when he was born. And it was winter time, and it was pretty darn cold. And I come downstairs to get dressed. We slept upstairs, but it was warmer by the heating stove. And my gosh, there was a baby basket there and a kid in it. Charlotte Leahy was out in the kitchen with my mom, and I thought, what the heck is Charlotte doing here this early in the morning with her baby? And after a while, it dawned on me, it wasn't Charlotte's baby. After that, comes Sheila. She was born in November of 39. I remember when Sheila left, yeah, Pat and Mike were babies. And how I hated to see her go, but yet I was happy at the same time. I don't know, it was just a thing I never really expected from our family. I didn't think we'd have a nun or a priest out of that, but we did. So that was a big surprise and a good thing. And Pat was born in September of 43 maybe, and Peg was born in May of 44. She took 2 or 3 weeks to get here. And the whole time, Mom would go to Blair and stay a week and nothing happened, so she'd go home and then she'd go back. And finally, Peg was born on the 2nd of May of, I believe it was 44. And that was the end of the line. When I went to high school, I went to Calhoun my first year. Johnny and I, you know, we hoofed it or rode a bus or whatever way we could get there and back.
She was coming home from school one night, and this kid that lived along the road, he thought he was going to have some fun with her. So he caught a bull snake, and he was going to scare her with that snake. Well, he chased her with the snake, and of course, she wasn't scared of damn snake. She'd seen him for hundreds of times, you know. So she finally took the dang snake away from him and used it for a whip and beat him up.
The second year, I got a job during the summer time with some people in Omaha babysitting and doing dishes and that type of thing. And they decided that I could stay there during the school year if I wanted to and take a little less money. I got $5 a week. No, I got $3 a week to start out. And so I did. I lived with them and I went to Sacred Heart the rest of my high school years. And never did get back home. I always kind of missed that. I mean, I'd come home on weekends, but that was kind of like leaving home pretty young. We used to have a lot of friends come out and we'd just run around the neighborhood doing different things. Everybody thought it was fun because most of my friends were not used to being on a farm. And everywhere we went, we had Pat, Peg, and Sheila with us.
And it was like we were little tag-alongs, no matter where her friends went. And I think they, as high school kids, would have liked a little privacy, and we were always there.
One of my friends, her name is Kate Dorsey, decided that their names should be the Bad Time Trio.
I can remember this one, Catherine Dorsey, who later became a Cincinnati Dominican. She, we used to just follow them along wherever they went. And I can remember one time she turned around to me and she said, "I told you I loved you, now get out." She was sick of having us tag along.
One of the sisters that taught us at Sacred Heart didn't like that name. She would change it to the Gleesome Threesome. Pat and Peg were like my, and so was Sheila as far as that goes, they were like my kids. That was hard for me to leave home at 18 or 19 when I got married. I was almost 19. And that was the biggest, hardest thing, was to leave the family, because I felt like I'm leaving my kids. Well, I met my husband Francis Dillon at another Dillon wedding back in 1948. After many decisions and disagreements and agreements, like how many kids we're going to have, I wanted 10 and he thought 3 was too many. Oh, why not? I mean, I come from a family of 9, so we decided we'd go ahead and get married. We married in June 1949 and I moved to Gretna. There was Jim, who was born in September of 53, and Pat and Mike, Patricia and Michael, born in February of 57. Jim has 2 children, so, and Pat has 3, so I got 5 grandchildren. You don't think about it. I have trouble with emotions. But you don't think about it. When things are happening,
you know, when they're young and all that. But I think now of what Tom went through as a kid. Because you know how frustrating it must be to not be able to, you know, do the things the other kids did, but he always did them anyway. And then we treated him just like we treated everybody else, which I guess was the right thing to do. And the same thing with Mike. He had to suffer with the diabetes. And it just seems to me that sufferings that they went through kind of covered for the rest of us. We all got our own little things. But it seems to me like there was a lot of grace there. Just to know that they took their lot in life is just in stride, you know. Just like, well, this is the way it is.
If you ever go across the sea to Ireland, it may be at the closing of your day. You will sit and watch the moon rise over Clada and see the sun go down on Galway Bay.
And if there's going to be a life hereafter, and somehow I am sure there's gonna be, I will ask my God to let me make my heaven in that dear land across the Irish Sea.